Doyen's intestinal occlusion clamp. So I am going to discuss about this instrument. Okay, so this is the picture of the instrument. As like any other instrument, this instrument has got these parts. Okay, number one, this is the blade, and this is the joint, and this is the shaft. This one is finger bows and this one is ratchet. Okay, so this is a, if you see this instrument is a longer instrument. Okay, so as the name infers that the instrument is useful to occlude the intestine. So this is the instrument, the same instrument in opened position. Okay, so this instrument, it comes in either as a straight instrument or a curved instrument. Okay, for example, so it appears like this the blade. The straight means the blade appears straight, or the blade appears curved in nature. So that is the first thing. And next one, if you see the blade, inside the blade, okay, if you see the inside the blade, there will be vertical serrations. Okay, so these vertical serrations will be present throughout the blade. Okay, and the next one is the main use. What is the use of this instrument? It is useful for intestinal resection and anastomosis. And the method of sterilization is autoclaving. What are the indication of the intestine resection and anastomosis? Okay, so this instrument is specifically useful to occlude the intestine while doing intestinal resection and anastomosis. What are the indications? Number one is a hernia. So not a simple hernia. Hernia with a strangulation. If the bowel is strangulated, then you can plan for the intestinal resection and anastomosis. Then any cause of intestinal obstruction that is causing the impairment of the blood supply, gangrene of the bowel, there also you can do the intestinal resection and anastomosis. And similarly, the intussusception, that is also one of the cause for the intestinal obstruction. Then neoplasms of the small intestine, either a benign neoplasm or a malignant neoplasm, there also you have to plan for the resection and anastomosis. Then intestinal tuberculosis, particularly the ileocecal tuberculosis, there you can plan for the resection anastomosis of bowel. Then any trauma to the bowel. And finally the Meckel's diverticulum. There you can plan for the diverticular resection and along with the resection and anastomosis. And finally, inflammatory bowel disease like ulcerative colitis, in which the it is not responding to medical treatment, or Crohn's disease that is presenting with fistula. In that case, you have to do the intestinal resection and anastomosis. Next, types of intestinal anastomosis. Okay, types. There are some types are there. I just show some pictures. Okay, suppose if you resect, these are the two curtains are there. Number one type is end-to-end anastomosis, which is nothing but you are taking these two ends together and you are anastomosing end-to-end. Another one, end-to-side. Okay, end-to-side, which is nothing but here suppose this is on one end, then this is another curtain is there. This is end to side. What you have to do, close this stump one end, and this end you take it to this aspect and create a stoma in the side aspect, and this is end to side. Now number three is the side to side. So what you have to do here, you got one cut end of the intestine, another cut end of the intestine, you create an stoma. Here you create an stoma in the side aspect. these two things you have to close. The end stoma you have to close, and side to side you have to do the anastomosis. This is side to side anastomosis. Then techniques. What are the techniques are there in intestinal anastomosis? There are two techniques are there. One is two layer technique, another one is single layer technique. What is this? Before going to the technique, I will tell you that how to do the resection and intestinal anastomosis. Okay, consider, so this is a part of a, consider this is a part of the small bowel. Okay, with okay, with this you can able to see the blood vessels that is through the mesentery. Okay, so this is the part of the small bowel, and if this is the gangrenous part of the bowel, so if this is the gangrenous part of the bowel, you have to resect this one. So what you have to do first, so the part, this gangrenous part, the blood supply, all the blood vessels you have to ligate in the mesentery. Okay, try to ligate the vessels that are supplying this part in the mesentery, creating the windows, and try to ligate the blood vessels. Then you occlude where you want to resect. You have to plan and you have to put an occlusion clamps, like so if you want to put an occlusion clamps, you try to level of dissection, resection you have to plan. Occlude two occlusion clamps, one on the proximal, another one on the distal. Here also you have to put two occlusion clamps, one on the proximal, another one on the distal aspect. That is one on the specimen side, another on the remaining side. You have to put on two occlusion clamps on both the sides. Then you go like a V manner from the anti-mesenteric border. From the anti-mesenteric border, you go like this, okay, go like this towards the root of the mesentery as a V shaped. Then you resect this bowel completely, this part of the bowel completely. Okay, then after that, you got the two cut ends of the bowel will be there. Okay, then now you plan for the anastomosis. Okay, this is one cut end. So I am going to discuss end-to-end anastomosis. Two cut ends are there. So single layer, as the name implies, that is you are going to suture full thickness of the intestinal wall. Okay, that is called single layer anastomosis. Okay, the two layers are there. What you have to do is this is the posterior layer. These two posterior layer, first you have to oppose, and this one is the anterior layer, this one is the anterior layer. So these two layers you have to close completely, full thickness. That is called single layer technique. What do you mean by the this one, like two layer technique? So two layer technique means there are two layers. One is the inner layer, another one is an outer layer. The inner layer is full thickness, that is full thickness you have to take, and outer layer is zero muscular layer. Okay, so there will be totally four layer you have to do. For example, I will tell you that you start from the zero muscular. Okay, so you start from the zero muscular posterior, from here to here, you start from the anterior mesenteric border. Okay, then start suturing. Once you start suturing, okay, this is posterior zero muscular suture. So this cut end and this is the, after suturing, the suture will come here. Then this is the first layer. Then you have to do the next layer. Okay, that is nothing but suturing this, that is a posterior inner layer. Okay, posterior inner layer. Okay, this one, and with this continuation you have to take the the continuation you have to take the anterior layer. This is the inner layer, posterior and anterior you have to complete. Then comes the last layer, that is the anterior seromuscular. So, okay, so this you have to start from here and you have to go like this. So either continuous or intermittent. Okay, so this is called a two layer anastomosis. So for ideally you should put a four layers you have to put, that is inner layer and outer layer, inner layer anterior posterior and outer layer anterior posterior. So that completes the anastomosis of the intestine. This is Doyon's intestinal occlusion clamp, the instrument opening and showing the vertical serrations of the blades.